And you can look forward to my first guest singing her latest hit, Perfect. But first, let's have a chat with Vanessa Amorosi. Welcome back.
Hello, hello.
Great to see you.
Thank you.
Now, your new single hits the stores this Saturday.
I know. It's nerve-wracking.
Long time coming?
yeah, definitely. I mean, we did the first single about 6 months ago and I just thought it would probably be the best way of describing the album is releasing something that's totally different to that. So that's why Perfect.
Now, the album's Somewhere in the Real World and that's due out in May.
Yeah.
Because there's so much that goes into an album, does it worry you then how it's going to be received?
Oh, definitely. And because I'm so close to the project doing all the writing and stuff, I mean, it's always nerve-wracking because it's actually my life in a song that I'm giving away. So, yeah, it's always scary to have people listen to it and have different opinions on it and to maybe not like it and maybe love it. So,
are you ever not happy? I mean, are you happy or do you think, oh, I could have done this or I could have done that?
Well, that's why it took me so long, because I'm forever not happy with what I do. I'm like, that can be done better. We're going again. We're getting back in there. But now, having it finished, I'm really happy with everything that's there. So.
And AFL, you've been involved in that now.
Yeah. I actually, heard one of the tracks. It's all about getting an adrenaline rush, and it's about sport to entertaining to anything that takes high energy. So they ended up hearing that track and loved it and wanted to use it for the football ad. Oh, yes, I was wrapped.
Well, we're going to have a little sample of it now.
Oh, it's just raining goals. It's a celebration.
Oh, plenty of action in that one. Sports seems to be coinciding with things that you do. You recently performed at the Formula One.
Yeah.
And supported Kiss.
Yeah, it's crazy times, I'm telling you. Things are just, it's amazing where music takes you and the opportunities you get. And, you know, the Kiss shows were amazing. And then doing the anthem was like the total opposite, all in the same day.
And were you a big Kiss fan?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I've always been a huge fan, so I was really, really rapt. I was actually quite nervous when I finished to do my little set when I walked off stage. They were all waiting there, and they're all, like, 7 foot tall. I was horrified. I was running run off the other side. But it was actually good. By the Sydney show, I was really quite relaxed, and they were really lovely people, so.
And you're into a bit of racing motorbikes yourself.
Yeah, I do a lot of track work. I mean, I used to do motocross when I was younger, and then I went into cars, and then I went back to road bikes, so.
Your mum has been a very big influence in your career and everything. Do you still take note of what she says today?
Even if I didn't, she'd make me. I think that's what mums have, that higher authority. They can always pull you back into line and make sense out of something that's not. So, yeah, definitely, she's still a major part of what I do.
Obviously very grounding.
Oh, yeah, yeah, of course. And, I mean, because we're all entertainers, it's no big deal being another entertainer. It's like, whatever. Mm. So there's not really a chance with our family to sort of become full of it, as I say. Mm.
Always an animal lover. Do you still have the llama and the camel?
The camel has gone away for racing season and the llamas are with my mum. And I'm on another property at the moment that I have a lot of Clydesdales through the drought that's gone through Victoria. I saved a lot.
Yeah. Tell me about the Penguin Foundation.
Well, they wanted me to be an ambassador the last time I went up there. I think it's something that we still have to keep quite preserved because, you know, with everything building up lately. So, yeah.
And so where's that? Where...
That's in Phillip Island.
Oh, yeah. I see. Oh, because the penguins are so gorgeous there,
aren't
they? Oh,
my God, they're so cute. I want to stick them in my handbag when they come up. Like, come on, little things, I'm the ambassador. I'll take care of you. Into my ass box.
So little cute.
I'll put you in my bathtub. It's all good. We'll be having fun. Yeah, no, they're keeping me away from the beach now.
But are they endangered at any point?
I think they're doing okay, but I just think that it's something that we do have to keep an eye on, you know, that they're still breeding and that we're not wrecking their little habitat there.
And you did a brief stint in the army as well.
Yeah, well, when I had the first album finished, I actually at 16 wanted to go to the army because it was sort of daunting being another musician among our family, and it was, I know the lifestyle a musician leads, you know, where you're never home, it's very hard to have a permanent income and have a family. So I thought, you know, well, I should just go to the army and just give this a rest. And then just as I was about to go, I had a single that took off back then.
Ah, yeah. So you never got to...
No, my mum was like, yes, supper!
Did they not want you to
No, my mum didn't want me, no, because I was going to drive trucks and disarm and mantle bombs. That's not something your mum wants you to do.
Funny about that. So do you have time for romance?
No, that's the problem with music, I suppose. I suppose also because I haven't found the right one. So when I do find the right one, I'll find an equal balance to managing, you know, my career as well as having a life among that. But
do you find being high profile that men find you intimidating?
Actually, yes. I was actually waiting. A lot of people go, oh, you know, you must be able to pick up really easy. No, it's actually the opposite. No one will approach you. Mm. And especially the guys I would like, which are more the shy, you know, reserved type of person, they won't approach, no way.
No.
I think we are.
Why, though?
Because we look scary. Well, I do.
You don't
especially
look scary
after a few drinks. They're running. No. I don't know. I think if they do come and approach me, they're usually the ones that are so drunk they can barely talk. So anyway, it doesn't bother me.
There's not much hope for me if someone like you can't get a fella, let me tell you. But I find that too. I find that intimidating word being used all the time.
Yeah. Yeah, I can see that. I wouldn't want to go and talk to another celebrity, I think. I think I'd be pretty intimidated if there was a male or a singer that I'd grown up listening to go over and say, hey, what you doing? It would be a bit scary.
I hadn't thought of it that way.
No.
Now, you are coming back to sing your latest single, Perfect.
Yeah.
Looking forward to that. You love it?
I'm wrapped. I'm really, really happy with it. And it's been fantastic, the support I've had for it. It's been overwhelming. So it makes me want to sing more and get out there more.
Well, we can't wait. Vanessa, thank you so much and good luck with it all.
Thank you.
Pleasure. That's Vanessa Amorosi. And if you'd like details of Vanessa's single or her album, just log on to our website. Vanessa Amorosi, and she's accompanied on guitar by Simon Hosford, and she is performing her latest single, Perfect. Please take care. Bye for now.
Stay forever. Change a thing because you're perfect. You sway gently in the breeze in between my dreams. It kind of makes me nervous. You storm. Still be worth it, yeah. In my dreams, you were perfect. When I woke up, you were perfect. Even when you run, you're still perfect. Barriers have never fallen down. The way you end should be the way you were found. Oh, in my dreams you were perfect. Perfect, so perfect.